Okay, so we're going to do a little chat about shutter speed today with some examples. Yay! It's show and tell time. This is a photo of my dog Ditto taken in the backyard. I had my stepfather throw it a little piggy so the dog can come and fetch it. I had him throw it at an angle so it wasn't coming directly at me, so it would be better for the autofocus to hit. Which it did, as you can see. I managed to freeze him. Got nice detail. He's good and sharp. The pig is out of focus. That was just a fluke. I think it almost hit me. That's why it's in frame. I used the shutter speed about 1/1000th, an ISO of about... I tried to go 100. Maybe I had it a little bit higher because I remember this was overexposed and I had to bring it back a little bit. The aperture was about 7.1 to 8 to try to get the whole dog in focus. As you can see, the focus starts to fade towards the tail, but you get the whole dog coming into the frame. I like it. It's a good action shot. It's a fun action shot to do. I love the fact that there's all kinds of little detail of all the snow being kicked up. But that's a good example of when to use a really fast shutter speed if you want some really fast action. And I'll show you how doing something similar with a bad ISO and a shallow depth of field is really luck of the draw. So that's this next one, which is again of Ditto, different time of year, obviously. And if you look at it, it's ISO 800, f3.2 and 1/800th of a second, which is kind of a fluke that I even managed to get the dog in focus. Because f3.2, when the dog is coming at you fast, is really like no chance. I try to think of it like apertures, like a slice of pie, and the more narrow, more wide open you are, the smaller the slice of pie is, the more closed off you are, the more slice of the pie you get. So like an f8 or f11, you're going to get the whole dog in focus. f1.8, 2.8, 3.2, you're going to be fluking if the camera manages to lock on. But the camera managed to lock on this one. So I'm happy with the results. It's a good little action shot. I like Ditto. Looks very cute. She looks menacing in photos, but she's really quite a sweet dog. So you could try this if you want. The ISO was up so high because it was at sunset and the sun was going down. I wanted to have, I know ISO waters down the overall exposure, but I wanted to bring in something because I didn't have like any off-camera flash or anything to illuminate the dog. And the next one is, here's an idea of slow shutter speed. This was taken inside my stepfather's car. And what we were doing is I had a tripod, two legs jammed into the backseat cushions, and one leg at the center console of the camera on the tripod. And I had it set to a 30-second exposure, ISO 100, and an aperture of like f11. And for 30 seconds just driving around this way, you can get. It's pretty easy, but I would recommend, I always set the camera to auto exposure delay. So that could go up to 3 seconds, so that means after you press the shutter button, you're not going to get shutter shock or shutter shake from you touching the shutter release. But as an added thing, I also put the camera on timer mode for at least 5 seconds. For almost 10 seconds, there's no shutter shock coming from me. It's most likely coming from the car because the car is moving, but it's not from me actually touching it. It took us about an hour driving around to get this, and I like it. It took about an hour before we actually got straight lines, and that's Montreal Road here in Ottawa, if you're from Ottawa. Here is an example of outdoor photography. A waterfall over in Gatineau, Dunlop Trail or whatever. I had the camera on a tripod. I had it set to a 2.5 second exposure. I put it up to f13 and an ISO of 50 because the D800E goes down to ISO 50 at its lowest. And I had a 9-step ND filter screwed on the front of it. So this is what I got. I believe I overexposed a little bit. I had to bring back the highlights a bit, but not by much. I was kind of pushing it. It was kind of the wrong day to be doing a super slow exposure like this, but this is an example of what you get when you have a tripod. A lot of these shots have tripods. Okay, maybe not. Never mind, I'm a liar. Two of them have a 3 after I left. Anyway. Don't listen to me. I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyway. This is an example of a little bit overexposed. Where you can get... See, that camera just shook because I need it. Sorry. Anyway. A little bit overexposed where you can pull back the highlights and you still have good detail. I like it. You go there, depending on the time of the year, it's either a trickle or it's an absolute raging monsoon of water. And here's an example of a slow shutter speed. And you're still getting motion blur like it's going fast. So this is just an example of panning. When I was in my apartment, I was on the fourth floor. I saw this vehicle coming. Used my 70 to 200 lens. Locked on autofocus on it, and I just started shooting away in continuous high, I think probably like 20 shots or something, from left to right, whilst I was panning following the car, until it disappeared by the edge of the building. So I was shooting at 1/60th of a second, like F11, ISO 400, and then when you're panning like that, the slower shutter speed will give you a motion blur, so even though technically everything should be in focus, it's like the movement cancels out the focus of the entire picture and it just all zeroes in on where you lock on focus to begin with. I try panning. People pan panning. I don't buy it. I like panning. Panning's fun. And here's an example. This is an example of a heron that I took, obviously, and I had to use a shutter speed of 1/1000th, aperture of f7.1, and my ISO was about 100, 200, 400. It was pretty dark that day, so and the bird was moving, so I was trying to freeze it and keep it in focus all at the same time, and keep it properly lit, because the sky was cloudy. And it was dark, and it kept on going from shade to light, shade to light, shade to light. So with that fast shutter speed and the aperture, I was able to freeze it and keep detail in the bird. And here's another example of a heron. And this is more of a tricky shot because it was completely backlit. It had the ISO 400, F8, and 1/500th of a second. The 500th of a second was fine for freezing the bird at this, because he was not going fast. He wasn't moving fast at all. That was fine. The ISO, I know it waters down exposure, but I had it to try to shoot in a little bit of brighten up the shadow side, because the first side of the bird's face was facing me, which was in shade. It's a kind of a dicey game with this, because sometimes you might blow out highlights because of just the time of day. I guess you could put a polarizer or something on your camera, and then, I don't know, don't listen to me. Good idea. F8, perfect, got lots of detail, could even see the Canada goose in the background. Lots of detail on the bird. ISO, it depends on what you want to do. Typically, the lower the ISO, the faster the shutter speed. But if you're too fast of a shutter speed, it's going to be black. Right, so it's kind of one of those variable things. You have to go up and down, up and down, up and down. And we will finish off with this. This is the Skywheel Niagara Falls, as you can read, if you can. tripod, 30-second exposure. It was an aperture of like F11. And ISO 100, I just plucked down a tripod and I let her rip. This is where you get when you have some fun. Oh well, that's all I got for you now. Have a good day.